So the question is, what bargaining power do new writers or directors have to secure the signature on an NDA from someone they are pitching an idea to? Further, what are the ramifications of deciding to pitch or not pitch if the individual they're pitching to does not sign an NDA? Well, nothing can force a person, a film company, TV company, etc., to sign a non-disclosure agreement. So newbies to the entertainment industry typically find themselves without much firepower, at least when first starting out. However, an individual's novice status in show business does not necessarily mean that they are completely without options. So let's explore. If an industry decision maker who's being pitched an idea for a film, a TV show, whatever, will not sign a non-disclosure agreement or an NDA, another option to pursue is an implied contract. Implied contracts can be oral agreements which are later followed up on by some written confirmation of understanding reached between the parties, the disclosing party of the idea and the receiving party of the idea. A simple email after the discussion, meeting these specifications will do, in fact. Now, it's not the best or the most sound or savvy of legal alternatives to the NDA, but it beats nothing. Because the implied contract is such a subjective document, it's literally just implied, the implied contract is more vaporous than the heavy-hitting NDA. Established film, music producers, etc., companies, they know that too, so, you know, there's that. Anyway, entertainment today seems to have settled more into a gamble, though. Some film houses, production companies, whatever, sign anything. Some will sign nothing. The trend, however, seems to be defaulting towards signing, mainly since signing forms now generally protects film and entertainment companies as well. You see, once upon a time, signing releases and non-disclosure agreements and the like pretty much were generally perceived as protecting the creators, the writers, the people doing the pitching, etc. Now, personally, I've seen the evolution of both extremes through the years. Back in my early 20s, late 80s and early 90s, I remember no one would sign anything, NDA, implied contract, or otherwise. It was kind of par for the selfish 80s me generation and largely the cliche of paying one's dues. You passionately pitched something with one hand on your heart while the other was tightly clenched in a fist, hiding crossed fingers for good luck. Anyway, new writers, directors, they spend lots of time in conflicting prayers oscillating somewhere between please God let them buy my pitch and please God don't let them rip me off. So there's that. Technology, worldwide accessibility, well, kind of changed everything. Seems like more and more production companies, producers, etc., did a complete reversal in the litigious 1990s and beyond, with now everyone suddenly signing everything. I mean, many production companies shifted to even company policy where no pitch meetings would be held at all, whatsoever, without non-disclosure agreements and, well, everything else imaginable being signed. It was the living cliche of having a meeting about signing papers for the upcoming meeting. So, what are the ramifications to the newbie who's starting out, who finally gets that coveted pitch meeting, but with a production company or a producer that simply will not sign a non-disclosure agreement, or anything for that matter? Well, there's always the risk of an idea being stolen, so let's be clear on that. So if one pitches to a crowd that refuses to sign, know that going in, it could be stolen. So there's the obvious risk. However, as I mentioned, the industry trend is increasingly gravitating towards signing to basically lessen the legal drama all around. Of course, the other side of the argument is that no one doesn't have to pitch anything. But in an industry where there is always a million-dollar idea literally next up in the pitch line to the producers, well, the risk is that not pitching will see the chance one gets literally evaporating right before their eyes, and poof, well, you know, lightning never strikes the same place twice, so to speak. So there's the risk there in not pitching to the decision makers who will not sign an NDA. Hello,